Please stay tuned at the end of this show for a new up-and-coming artist, Miss Anna DAnae, performing at the Myths Harlem with host Reggie Wells.
Hello, and welcome to Pipe TV, where we extend the experience of getting to know our featured guest up close and personal.
Hey, welcome back to Pipe TV. This is your girl, Miss Tonni, bringing Photography Insight Plus magazine to life here today. In the studio, we have a legendary actor director, someone that's here to share his story of his career, of where he was, where he's been, and what he's doing now. So it is my honor to be in the presence of the great legendary John Canada Terrell.
Wow.
Hello.
I don't know how to live up to all that.
Uh-huh.
My God, you burped me.
Yes. So welcome. Thank you for coming through.
No, thank you. I'm having a flashback. It's wonderful.
Are you really?
Yeah.
Okay.
It's well, Freudian stuff.
Look, we have a lot to discuss.
Sure.
And basically, I want to start with your career on where you started. I know you've been in this industry for, what, over 30-something years.
Yeah, wow.
Right? Doing over 40 films, theater,
TV
production.
Mm-hmm.
I mean, the accolades goes on, okay? So I'm hearing that you actually started in theater.
Yeah, yeah.
All right,
right,
we'll talk about that.
Let me see, Afro-American Studio Theater in Brooklyn and then the Billie Holiday Theater Ensemble.
Yes,
in Brooklyn.
I've heard of that,
Ernie
yes.
Ernie McClintock, Billie Holiday Theater, I was part of the ensemble. Where else? Frank Zubair's Writer's Workshop.
I've heard of that.
I was always doing reading with Samuel Jackson. Well, everybody that's famous was there.
Yes, yes.
Shedding,
so
working
that's
on shows.
Why I use that word legendary, because you are part of that little package there. Legendary.
I came out of a good era.
Yeah, you did.
Yeah.
You did.
They're open doors.
Yeah. Do you remember the first play you've actually did?
The first one here in New York City that I got in kind of accolades and was really challenged, I played the lead in. It was in Harlem at the New Lafayette Theater. Yeah, right there on 137th Street, 7th Avenue. Played Big Eyed Buddy, Lomax, Tambourines of Glory. I played the devil.
Okay, double.
The devil.
Oh, the devil.
Yeah,
okay.
Essentially that's what the character was based on.
All right.
And what happened, I ran into Calvin Lockhart at After Hours Spot.
Okay.
And he saw me with a script. It's 3 or 4 o'clock in the morning. He's like, yeah, you trying to be actor? Man, I'm trying to be like you. What you got? Oh, let me explain your character. He did. I'm like, it scared me. I'm that dark? Yes. And I did it his way.
Oh,
and I got
wow.
nominated for an Adelco Award.
Look at you. Yes.
Yeah.
You got actually a lot of awards under your belt.
I got
well.
Nominated a lot.
Yeah.
But I won a few.
Yeah. You gradually did also move into film.
Yeah.
Was it hard to make that transition? You know, what was it like? Was it different? Was theater different than film?
Well, it's a different medium. Mm-hmm. I knew the dynamics of the difference, but I had worked with so many actors that had already done film.
Right.
My mentoring was like kind of on point. Mm-hmm. And the first film that I got any kind of lead role was, of course, She's Gotta Have It.
Yes, and I was just about to go there too.
Ruben Santiago
yes.
Hudson turned down the role because for whatever reasons.
For him.
For whatever reasons. I just happened to call Spike that particular
yeah.
day. He said, well, John, come on, I'm gonna give you a script tomorrow. Don't mess with that girl. I'm like, what? What? Give me the script, come on.
For those that don't know, that is actually a Spike Lee's film, first back in 1986.
That first got a distribution
yes.
deal.
Yes.
But I did
yes.
Joe's Bed-Stuy Barbershop with him, no, and I did The Duel 1946 with him and Ernest, because they were partners then.
Right.
They were at NYU. So it was like, this is where you get your chops, doing NYU films.
Correct.
So I met them out the gate. Ang Lee was
that.
A sound man.
Yes.
Just doing all the Marvel comic
yes.
books.
Yes, yes,
yeah,
yes.
Just so.
You've been around.
In the beginning.
In the beginning.
Yeah.
In the beginning. Which leads me to your other film that has been up and around. Well, let me go back for a quick minute, because you disappeared out of film for a while.
Yeah.
And I'm hearing that it's mainly because of that character that you were playing in She's Gotta Have It, character Greer.
That had an effect. And then after the heartbeats, I mean, it's kind of like, be careful what you wish for, you might get it. Mm-hmm. So invariably, as your dreams become come to fruition, okay, that's one thing, but there's no book in acting school or mentoring that can prepare you for any kind of fame in a city with 10 million people.
Yeah.
So if you do a major black film that all of a sudden people are hungry to see, and then you do some backup stuff, and then I had a national commercial on for 30 years selling black love albums.
I
couldn't walk
that.
Down the
I
street day or night.
Uh-huh.
So that was a little frightening, and how do you make that adjustment?
Yes.
And then it affects your social life, your family life, because you're the same person, and they think you went Hollywood, and all that. I'm just living my dream. You changed.
Correct.
And you, and it's a little strange.
Has there actually been any characters that you were given in either theater or film that you could say, that character is like me, that's who I am, or have all your characters been opposite of who you are?
That's a really good question. If the doors that opened to me were more or less based on who's going to be the next Billy Dee Williams, and this ain't no Jerry Curl and I got real muscles, so I'm just clear this
that's
up.
Real, y'all, what you see is real, it's real.
So if that's opening the door, okay, but am I suave and cool? No, I'm silly, but I'm daring.
Mm-hmm.
And I can charm the leaves off a tree if I put my mind to it, I mean, if I want to. But I'm silly.
Uh-huh.
So everything's really against my real inner me. Am I suave and bubbly? No, I can play smooth.
Okay.
I can lie like a Persian rug. I can make a suit look good. I can, I can do all kind of stuff. I could break bricks. I could beat somebody to death in Chinese or Japanese.
And I was going to go there too, because I don't know if anybody knows behind the scenes, you're actually a sensei.
I'm actually a master instructor as of last year.
Look at that.
Yeah, but I prefer sensei.
Okay.
Because I'm surrounded by killers.
Yeah.
And they test my skills.
If you guys don't know, sensei is actually a teacher, an instructor in martial arts. How long have you been doing that?
For about 30 years.
Wow.
I made Shodan when I did She's Gotta Have It, 1987. But, Master Lil John. I was trained in Sanukis Ryu, Kamite Ryu, but now I teach Taekwondo and Jiu-Jitsu.
Oh, wow.
So I cross-train.
Yes, yes.
Yeah.
Amazing.
It's fun.
A man of many talents.
No, I'm doing my own stunts.
Yeah, yeah. And he does his own stunts. Oh, wow.
Well.
Look, there's also another film that everybody does know you for, and that's the character Flash in The Five Heartbeats.
Is that your man? Are you guys happy?
I'm married.
That's good. Can I use your pen? Here's my number. Take it.
Just in case.
What you doing, JT?
Not all that he seems.
Oh, just in case.
It's not what it should be.
Like you're holding it. Squeeze me tighter, baby. How do I feel? Good, huh? Just in case you have any second thoughts, I'm gonna leave you with this.
J.T. Matthews.
How did you snatch up that role?
Robert Townsend was hanging out with us when we did She's Gotta Have It and went to the Cannes Film Festival.
Okay. Mm-hmm.
Robert had a half a film, Hollywood Shuffle.
Mm-hmm, mm-hmm.
So we went there with the only black film at the Cannes Film Festival with a terrorist threat, so all the major white stars did not show up.
Right.
We the only fools showing up from continental United States
right.
with a black film that all of Europe was curious about. So they got all kind of accolades, and now we're getting 62 worldwide interviews, and Robert's hanging out because nobody else speaks English but us. We're just sticking together. So he got his distribution deal because of She's Gotta Have It. So when Five Heartbeats came around, I did not have an audition. But Robert's my Negro.
Mm-hmm.
So when he shows up at the casting thing, knowing that I have to respect the casting person, hey, Robert's gonna knock on the door. Hi, I know I don't have a Robert, welcome to New York. We're gonna hang out later on. We're going to the strip club. I got you. Man talk. John, you don't have to, you're right. John, stick around. I'm like, well, okay, Robert, she's a little pissed. John, are you in shape? I will jump up and kick the light bulb out the ceiling. What, how kind of shape? You gonna play Flash. Well, is that good? You're a co-star. Thank you, Robert.
Right.
You ain't got no, thank you, Robbie Reed, I love you. I
right,
gotta go.
Right.
See you later.
Yes.
She ain't liked me since.
Oh, wow. Wow.
So that's kind of how I got it.
Okay, and I've always was curious with the roles, with the Five Heartbeats. Were you guys actually singing, or was that somebody else?
I'll never tell.
Aww!
I mean,
to give us an exclusive here.
You got to realize we had Michael Peters teaching us how to dance, mm-hmm. and I got three different groups, so they danced me into the. I'll never say I'm in shape,
right?
Ever to a producer, because they're like, "Oh, really?"
Right, right.
Right? They gonna dancing
test
for
you.
Three different groups, right?
Yeah, they gonna test you.
Then I had a vocal coach, Seth Ribbs, who was the vocal coach for Michael Jackson and Anita Baker,
oh, wow.
$200 an hour for 6 weeks. So
yeah,
dance lessons,
yes.
singing lessons for 6 weeks. Now go into the studio and sing the song. They sweeten it up. Now you got to sing to your own track.
Right,
I could do that.
Right, right.
I'm in three different groups.
Oh, wow.
They literally had to cut some of my stuff because like, it's really about Eddie King Jr. I'm his foil.
Mm-hmm.
I just chose not to play it the way they wanted me to play it.
Okay.
Well, I mean, what are your choices? You play the subtext, right? If you're an actor, the subtext. And if you're honest to the subtext, well, do I play jealous or envious or ambitious? These are choices.
Mm.
These are internal choices. And if he's my boy, I'm like, why am I going to be jealous of one of my boys?
Yeah,
I know
ambitious.
That Negro. I'm ambitious.
I got you.
Different choice.
I got you.
Yeah.
Wow.
It worked for me.
I see.
They allowed it.
I see.
Thank God for Robert.
Well, definitely, you know, John, you've been a pioneer in the modern black cinema, definitely. And as an insider now, where do you see the future of African-American films going?
Boy, don't you ask some loaded questions. Oh,
absolutely. Absolutely. I need to know.
There are some films I'm dying to see.
Okay.
The Harriet Tubman film.
Yes,
now.
Yes, yes.
Mixed reviews because we opened doors.
Yes.
And some of my work has been part of that door opening.
Mm.
Along with Spike and Robert, the Hudlin Brothers.
Mm-hmm, mm-hmm.
Well, here we are now with black stories being told and they're being distributed around the world with those doors being open.
Mm-hmm.
Well, what happened to the black actors here that are trained at the Actors Studio, the British American Acting Academy, the Roundabout Theater Conservatory, where I happen to have studied, mm-hmm. and along with some others that are very well trained.
Yes.
That have skills, that have chops, that have filmography and theater awards. Well, why get an English actor? I'm having
right.
some problems.
Right.
Now, I like to see black people work, but what about the indigenous black people that made this possible for them to come over here from England?
Right.
I'm just saying.
Hmm. And he left that open, so yeah.
You know, be that as it may.
Yes, yes, yes.
You know.
So now looking forward, you've touched on theater, mm-hmm. you've done TV production, you've done film.
Mm-hmm.
Are you headed back to theater? Because I believe the last theater that I actually saw you in, well, not saw you, but I watched the video of it, was when you did Do You Trust Your Best Friend?
I know you know how to make me feel good.
Babe, we've been together for 2 years. If I don't know what make you feel good by now, I should really be ashamed of myself.
You're so good to me, Maurice.
I got paid today. Take what you need and pay all the bills.
Are you You know what? I gotta call Toya and tell her this.
No, hey, April. Do you have to tell Toya every little thing that we do?
June 13th. Girl, I'm getting married.
You make a mind and I'm gonna take care of everything.
Yes.
Hey, congratulations!
Thank you for the fourth time, Tony.
Sure, use a good foot massage. I mean, April did say you were really good with your tongue.
Because of you, with the help, my gym business is doing great. But I want you to be the general manager. But the job is in the ATL.
Atlanta?
And you know what, baby? While we celebrating, how about we just go ahead and change that reservation to 3 instead of 2?
For who?
Babe, it's for Toya.
I don't want any other brothers. Thank you.
How about we just skip dinner? Because you got me wanting some dessert.
Stop being in my crib when I'm not here, man, okay?
Come on, man. Is anyone here to talk to your best friend?
And if you think for 1 minute that I'm going to allow your devilish behavior to come into our home, girl, you're sadly mistaken.
Can you believe our baby is getting married?
Then Maurice, he treats my baby so good. I guess I'm gaining one heck of a son.
When last time you've been to church, man?
See the look in my eye? I want you for myself.
Girl, watch your damn mouth. That's my fiance you talking about. Now sit your ass down and be happy for your best friend.
About to do that again, I think.
Are you really?
In December. But you gotta realize,
I need to get there.
When I had problems with the fame and whatnot years ago, right. I made a conscious decision, and my mother died here in New York. I didn't handle grief well, so I had to go back to where I owned some real estate, where I was educated. Go to Philly and figure stuff out.
Yes.
And when I figured stuff out,
is done in Philly.
Yeah.
Absolutely.
I went back to stage I'm comfortable on. Well, on that note, to revisit stage, all right, where do I go? Chitlin Circuit. I was in Clifton Bowles. I said, man, get some of that money on Chitlin Circuit. You got a name, go there. Mm-hmm. I did 10 national tours over a 10 year period. Marvin Gaye Straight, the Silky Smooth Soul Singer, My Brother Marvin, No Place to Be Somebody, mm-hmm. which was a Pulitzer Prize winning mm-hmm. show, I might mm-hmm. add, mm-hmm. with Antonio Fargus, Philip Michael Thomas. I'm in good company.
Dropping those names.
No, but I've worked with the best.
Yes.
So my point being, when I went there, it was like healing. It's like, wow, I've been around, and then now you're getting love because there's a live audience and people are meeting you like, no, but I've been watching you for years. I'm like, thanks for making me feel old. That's just really lovely.
Yes.
But you're getting love. Yeah. You don't get love from a camera.
Correct.
You seduce the camera,
right.
But it ain't loving you back.
Correct.
It might be kind to you, mm-hmm. but it ain't loving you back. Right. So I had to go back to where my instincts evolved from.
Right.
It was great.
And you're feeling at home there, right?
Oh, I'm doing the Haley Jackson story in about 2 weeks at the Met in Philadelphia. Then I work with Darrell Lawrence again.
Oh,
and
wow.
then I have a 3-picture deal for 3 horror films.
Okay. I'm going to keep following you because I need to get there and watch that.
Well, I
need to see you.
I just want to beat up the bad guy. So
that's all right. I'll
be a monster. Let me get the monster.
I'll watch you beat him up. And now, right now, what are you doing now? Because I'm hearing that you also have your own production projects coming out. Specifically, this one, Mediation of Dangerous Fools.
Oh, I had a one-man show called Meditation of a Dangerous Fool. I wrote a one-man
right.
show. I took it to black colleges, and that was quite an experience. Mm. Made some money,
mm.
but it was... you know, you have to share with the next generation of black intelligentsia. Talented 10th, let me talk to you before you get ruined by those professors.
Right.
Because they're really not educating you.
Right.
And are they,
right.
you getting your money's worth? I don't think so. So get mad at me, teacher. Get mad at me.
I got you. Well, look, before we actually let you go, I mean, it's been a pleasure. I don't want to let you go. But before we let you go, what can you share with one thing that your fans don't know about you?
Oh, I'm a fun kind of guy, I'd like to think.
I think they know that already.
I think the best is yet to come. Some of the stories I'd like to tell, if blessed to do them, I can't wait to do that. Mm. I want to be challenged. I'm going to stay on stage till I die. I'm a griot till I die. I'd like to be the next Morgan Freeman.
Whoa.
So it's still on, and all you A-list actors, watch it.
Yeah.
Don't let me get the right role.
That's so true, right?
I'm just saying.
Because your personality is just popping. I mean, even on screen, on theater, I mean, let me tell you guys. Right now, I want to thank you for coming through. Thank you for taking the opportunity to sit here and share your story. I know there's so much more that we want to hear from you.
I had a ball here. I get to talk to your techies. I'm having a flashback. I was on the set with you.
He was here so early, just, you know, roaming the whole building. This is like his home, you know,
yeah.
Bringing him back memories. But I want to thank you. I want you guys to definitely follow John through his all his works, all his projects that's coming up. At the end of the show, we're going to give you everything that you need when his next when he'll be on stage the next time. So you guys got to follow, and I'll probably be there.
I hope so.
Follow me also. And I want to just thank you, the viewing audience, for taking the time to share this stage with the studio today with John Canada Terrell.
Thank you, Miss Tonni.
Yes. And this is your girl, Miss Tonni, and you are watching Pipe TV.
And now, here is a rising star, Miss Anna DAnae.
My girl, this is the last one.
Thank you. Once again, ladies and gentlemen, please give it up for me. Let me just say this here. You know, I know some of y'all out there, you're not familiar with her. She's brand new. She's trying. She's ambitious. She's talented. She has a bright future ahead of her. Give her a round of applause. And some of y'all out there, I heard y'all saying, well, she's young. Yes, she's young.
She's amazing.
But let me tell you something. Back in, I think it was about 89, I had TLC, not in here, at this place called The Pulse.
Okay.
They was kids.
Yeah.
I had New Edition at Justine. They was kids.
Yeah. Yeah. Yes.
And y'all was doing the same shit until they had a hit record. Now y'all want to see it. This is how you start. This is the beginning. And one thing about it, she puts on a show.
Yes, she does.
So ladies and gentlemen, if you will, please give it up for them. And when you have your first hit record, make sure I get a gold or platinum.
You're going to get your 20%. Thank you, everybody.
Yes, indeed.